So when you talk about crowdfunding, basically, you're talking about bringing different groups of people together to fund some project. And we'll talk about the different forms of crowdfunding. If you remember back in the days when we had the whole concept of Karanja is basically where someone was going off to abroad to school abroad and needed funds and wanted different people to come and sponsor, starting with their company or their counselor, their family and friends. Karambe is basically crowdfunding. So if you think about crowdfunding, it's not a good concept. It's been in existence for hundreds of years. And these are the four forms of crowdfunding, where you have donation-based crowdfunding, which is basically SnoLegal forms part of donation-based crowdfunding. This is the one that is most popular across the globe. And of course, locally here, we've always been doing it through Harambe. Then you have lending-based crowdfunding, where you have different lenders lending to a particular cause, a particular business. And in terms of growth, donation has been declining, because this is an old concept. Then followed by lending. And then there you have equity-based crowdfunding. This is something new. That and the fourth, these are new concepts that are coming to the market where you have different people who are investing in a business, they want shares in that business, and they crowdfund, basically. If you look at stock listing in a stock exchange, it's a form of crowdfunding to some extent. And then the last one is reward-based crowdfunding. This is the most popular, where if you're starting a cause or action, give benefits, like what you have done. So in terms of SnoLegal, and she'll talk about the whole concept, it's a hybrid of both donation-based as well as reward, where she's promising some form of rewards to the people who participate in the raffle. Okay. So types of examples where you want to crowdfund, disaster relief. This happens all the time, like the Haiti disaster or when there's an earthquake somewhere, different countries come together. It's a form of crowdfunding. And then you have philanthropic ventures, which slowly go might form part of this. If you didn't know Sarah, and you contributed some money to her, it's a philanthropic venture. Then you have, of course, political campaigns. Political parties do this every time there's an election, where they source donations from different people. And then, of course, you have creative ideas and startups. And this is where Pesa-Fund particularly plays. So if you have a burning idea, sound and solid idea, and come to us and discuss the type of campaigns that you can run to get funding or get your idea going for you to improve your proof of concept. So, in terms of what has happened is that crowdfunding as a concept is something very, very old. So, what's happened with the advent of internet? What has happened is that we have crowdfunding platforms where people can actually donate. And that's what SnoLegal has done by leveraging off the power of the internet. And some of the platforms that has come about in the last 5 years or so, we have Kickstarter, which is almost a good thing in the tech industry. We've had a Kickstarter to global. And then, how many platforms there are globally? Said to be over 500 platforms. So the crowdfunding platforms there are so many out there. But Kickstarter tends to be the most sustainable, it's the most successful in the world. Then coming back to Africa, you have Indiegogo that's down south in South Africa. And in South Africa, you have about 15 crowdfunding platforms, which have not been very successful in terms of sustainability and also being around. Then coming back to Kenya, you have Pesa-Fund, and of course, you have M-Chat. What's happened with M-Chat? It's a form of crowdfunding platform. And what as Pesa-Fund, what we're trying to boost up is the growth of some of these crowdfunding platforms, because they're very important in terms of growth of ideas and businesses, as well as forms like SnoLegal. Okay. So Pesa-Fund, we're looking to operate both in Nairobi, Johannesburg, as well as in Lagos. We are creating people with great ideas that they want to do proof of concept. But we are looking for small amounts for you to build up your or to test your concept before you can get now either round A, venture capital funding. can get a group of people to contribute even small amounts like $5,000, equivalent to about a million shillings, just to get your idea across, prove it in the market. So that's what we do. Now, something about crowdfunding before I this is my last slide, I promise. One thing that has been critiqued is that funding in itself, especially for ideas and as well as even causes like car, you can't just do funding alone. You have to peg it together with other things. And from a business perspective, we need to talk about business support and we need to talk about solution providers. So what Pesa-Fund has tried to do in terms of crowdfunding is to bring all these role players together. It's not just about pushing out money. And even for causes like that, like, it's not just about issuing money. Yeah. I'm sure along the way, she talked about it. She got advice from different role players. And even the fact that she built up a raffle around it, it's not just about getting money or donations. It's about creating something exciting about it. And from a business perspective, it's important for us to do this today. And this is what a lot of the African platforms have done. It's not just about money. It's bringing all the work we have to do. If you have any questions, you can always engage after the event. But I'd like to introduce to the platform our main user manager. Please, come on. Please, Jason, and tell us more about it.
Good afternoon, everyone. Well, I think you've watched the video, so I won't delve too much into why and where and all that. I want to give you the details.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, the
people ask, what is the inspiration behind this? Quite simple. Money. You need a large amount of money and you don't have it. You need to find a way to get it. So we had several different ideas, no ideas. So we need to have it. funny enough, I talked to Betting Control and Licensing Board first, because you can't run a raffle without their permission. They were stumped, to say the least. They had no idea how to regulate a raffle, which isn't about a prize that is, you know, a physical thing, but time. So one of the major lessons I've learned is people actually value time and mentorship and not just physical things or assets. So that was a wonderful way to learn, because it really, as much as a social experiment for me, as it was for all the other candidates. Then a few fun stories that came up throughout my campaign, I'd say were just random people bumping into me and asking, yeah, that was a small legal thing. Yeah, kinda. No, but it's interesting because I took my posters literally everywhere. And it took me a few weeks because I saw my backpack on and walking to the police shop, after the police shop, after the police shop, trying to explain to them that it's a raffle. This is what you do. I just need you to put up a poster for me for it's free. Just tell people if they look at a poster, Google it, find all the information. So guys in DVD shops, guys in cyber cafes, people who own small restaurants, they were happy to help me out. And then of course there's some people who online as I was tweeting, they kind of fell into Sindikiza SnoLegal and were wondering what this is about. And luckily there's one of them here. It's called Mungai. He's here with us. It's actually invited over because he's been such a great support. I didn't know those were strangers. But he's also been retweeting everything that I've been saying. Then let's see. What kind of people have I met during this whole campaign? There are people who are philanthropic from the get-go, who are ready to give in 100 shillings a minute, then there are people who say this is a scam. So how do you handle people who say this is a scam? I actually engaged them. So they asked me very many questions. How sure are we this money is actually going to help your application? How sure are we actually got your mentors? How sure are we that those mentors are actually real? So it was a whole discussion about just go to YouTube, check out the videos. They mentioned my name with their own mouths. You can see their pictures. I gave them hold up my Sindikiza SnoLegal banners. They look like mugshots, some of them, but it worked. And most people think I paid celebrities' money to join my campaign. Not at all. In fact, they were happy to join. And all it took, the only money it took me,
regularly want.
even with the tweeting, there's a lesson. There's certain messaging, certain tones of the tweets that worked better than others. There's some tweets I said, been a fantastic opportunity with these mentors. Only $100. They didn't get as much response as this.
Group of people to talk, to listen to what you're doing,
give a lot of myself to the one that you want to be able to do. Then what I've realized is old is gold. As much as I have this grand idea of having this very powerful digital campaign, the best method of raising money, I'll have to say, mom was right, is just people sitting down saying, oh, then I'll be, where will you go? How will you get money to these people? Can we set a target? Let's set up a committee, have meetings, make sure we have targets for you, and you're going to deliver on these targets by this date. That's how we make the first video. Literally, my online campaign is still slow. And timing, I've realized timing is also essential. My campaign, fortunately, started in November and ended in January. I wanted it to end in November. But towards the end of November and the whole of December, I was faced with Kenya at 50 and Christmas and New Year's. So it was a battle to stay relevant when those holidays are there, because people are just busy, you know, party time. So even with the statistics, it will show that November I had a really good response. In January as well, but in between these apartments, I can say there's 1 week I think I had in 100 shipments coming. It was a bit depressing, but I understood and I let it go. And as well, people think that I've been called to all these radio shows because they've had my story and interesting. I walked into every single radio station that I could, talked to every single newspaper editor that I could. Sent emails to every single TV station that I could. I sent them links, I sent them PDFs, I sent them profiles of myself, and everything that I'm doing. And a small percentage of them was actually sent back to home, but that actually helped reach out to the wider audience. And of course, there's some, I'll say, TV hosts and radio hosts who people think would be excited about such kind of ideas. I mean, it's empowering the youth, and the truth is, they're not. That's the truth. Unless they see that there's something in front of them, there's something that will hype their own profile, they're not necessarily welcoming or open to having someone who is very determined and committed to their world. So that's the honest truth that is happening. And yeah, so that's pretty much it. But one last thing I have to say. Count out old people, the elderly and the retirees. That's where you get most of your money from, because these people have grown children who can take care of themselves. So more often than not, they have a bit of extra money to spend. So if you're going to have a crowdfunding campaign, reach out to your grandparents, your grandparents' friends, your grandparents' church groups, that was it. So I hope I've given you a bit more insight into the inner dealings of
just a quick reminder for those who can access Twitter. The event is live streaming, so you can tweet about the event, and if you have any questions, you can post them on Twitter as well.
So thank you, Sarah. I think that was a good. My name is John Karanja. I'm the founder of Whive. Whive empowers social individuals. So we develop concepts and applications for services as well as social media. So me and Sarah. Thank you. basically, what is the software is, it's open source, it's free. And one of the things you have to do, you have to make sure the website is not open. Because on your Twitter, you basically have to do it. So, you want to use something that's not safe. Just So this is the analytics.
Thank you.
See, Thank you.